G'day, I'm James Tanton, and this is Study Hall Algebra, presented by Arizona State University and Crash Course. Let me introduce myself. I'm a teacher, a mathematician, an Australian who loves lamingtons and pavlova, maybe just a bit too much, and a full-blown math enthusiast. But it might shock you to learn I wasn't born loving math. But I ended up getting a PhD from Princeton in algebraic topology, which is a fancy way of saying I spent a lot of time using algebra to study abstract shapes, and devoting my career to teaching math. So what happened? Well, it wasn't until my college years that I saw the humanity of mathematics. I finally realized that math is really about human thinking, doing, wondering, and exploring. But many people never get to see this. So I spent 20 years in the US teaching and spreading this message. And now I travel all over the world working with teachers and students to help everyone see math as abundantly joyful. It's my mission to clear the clutter and the jargon from the math and make it a space for inquisitive, human, empowering learning. For a lot of people, algebra can feel like a precarious stack of arbitrary rules that's ready to crash down at any moment. But that's where Study Hall comes in. In this series, we'll build up the concepts underlying algebra until we can see it as a beautiful foundation for the world around us, rather than just a heap of pieces. The word algebra itself actually comes from the Arabic algebra, which roughly translates to restoration, completion, or reunion. It was first used in a math context in the 9th century by the Persian mathematician Muhammad al-Khwarizmi, whose name is actually where we got the word algorithm, or mathematical program, from. Though the ideas of algebra stretch back way further. And this reunifying notion of algebra has actually made its way into a number of cultures and languages. When a character in the 17th century classic Spanish novel Don Quixote breaks his ribs, he sets off in search of an algebrista, a surgeon who specializes in mending or reuniting broken bones. But somewhere along our modern algebra quests, perhaps in dark classrooms with a lot of chalk, we've forgotten that idea of wholeness. So, over the 15 episodes in this learning playlist, we're going to rebuild our mathematical understanding from the ground up. We'll discuss what we're really doing when we solve equations, and answer age-old puzzles like why is negative times negative a positive answer? Or why we can't divide by zero, as we've always been told. There will be word problems, there will be graphs, there will be polynomials and logarithms and exponents. But throughout it all, we'll study truth by using logic and observing patterns. In fact, whether you're thinking of being a psychologist, a game developer, a senator, a marine biologist, a musician, whatever you do, algebra can help you learn how to think deeply and give you the confidence to analyze any problem. But the most important thing you're ever going to be is what you already are, a critically thinking human being who notices patterns, makes predictions, and solves problems. Algebra just sharpens those skills. So we'll not only solve our algebra homework, but we'll also see with our math goggles how relevant math is and how much math there is in the world around us. So let's get cracking. As a colleague of mine likes to say, let's solve for X and know Y. Thanks for watching Study Hall Algebra, which is produced by Arizona State University and the Crash Course team at Complexly. If you like this video and want to keep learning from us here at Study Hall, be sure to subscribe. You can learn more about ASU and the videos produced by Crash Course in the links in the description. See you next time.